إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. ثم أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. قال الإمام البربهاري رحمه الله تعالى في كتابه شرح السنة، قال: والإيمان بأن الله هو الذي كلم موسى ابن عمران عليه الصلاة والسلام يوم الطور، وموسى يسمع من كلام الله بصوت ووقع في مسموعه منه لا من غيره، فمن قال غير ذلك أو غير هذا فقد كفر بالله العظيم. إمام البربهاري رحمه الله تعالى he said in the point number 76 in this tremendous book that is called The Explanation of the Creed by Imam al-Barbahari. He said in point number 776, he said to have faith, meaning to believe, that it was Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the blessed one, the most high, who spoke to Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, the son of Imran, on the day of the Mount of Tur. He said, and that Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, he heard Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's speech. Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, he heard Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's speech. He said, a voice which he heard from him, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, not from any other else, meaning any other than him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he said, he who says other than this has indeed disbelieved in Allah the most sublime. Shaykh Fawzan hafidhahu Allah ta'ala explaining this point, he say, ithbatu kalamillah. In this point it is to affirm, to establish that indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks. And barakallahu fikum, it is always important to revise and to learn about the aqidah, the foundation of our deen. And this point, barakallahu fikum, it is one of these foundation of our deen that if one will misplace it, then that can cause his Islam to fade away, wal'iyadhu billah. And this is why, barakallahu fikum, Imam al-Barbahari rahimahullah, he bring this point, ithbatu kalamillah, affirming that Allahu jalla wa ala he speaks. And one will not feel yani bored about this issue. Or one will not say, why isn't it more important to speak about the people that is being killed in here or killed up there? The people being killed up here and being killed up there, it is part of the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, without a doubt. But the foundation of the deen, it is that which you will be asked yawm al-qiyam. Not why people were killed in Afghanistan or why people were killed in this. You will not be sa'ilun an dhalika. You will not be asked towards this. But rather, man rabbuka, who is the one that you use to worship? In other words, what is your deen? What is your aqidah? This is that which you're going to be asked yawm al-qiyam. And who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala words? Meaning, who is Allah? Who is your Lord? Do you ascribe that which he ascribed himself? Or do you deny, do you distort that which he ascribed for himself? So this is a point that is tremendously important, barakallahu jameer. It is what? It is to establish that indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is, he speaks. Shaykh Fawzan hafidhahu alayhi say, min usul al-aqidah, ahli al-sunnati wal-jama'ah, anna Allah yatakallam bikalamin haqiqi. He says it is from the foundation of the people of the Sunnah and Jama'ah, meaning those who hold on the deen that Abu Bakr as-Siddiq led to him, meaning those who are holding on to the same deen as Umar ibn al-Khattab and all the Sahaba. He says this is one of the foundation of their belief, is what? That they ascribe the kalam, meaning the speech, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He says, verily, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he spoke with to Musa. Truly, he spoke truly to Musa alayhi salatu wa salam. He say, Sami'ahu Jibreel alayhi salatu wa salam. He say that Jibreel heard this statement. He say, Wasami'ahu Musa alayhi salatu wa salam. And Musa alayhi salatu wa salam, he heard the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Lamma dhahaba ila an-nar. He say, when also, then Musa alayhi salatu wa salam, when he was going to look for the fire or the firewood or to look for something like the like of the fire, he said that when he went there, he said he heard the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, wa wajada anna Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yukallimuhu min ash-shajara. And when Musa was trying to gather the firewood or the fire or whatnot, he said, and he reached there, he realized that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was speaking to him from the tree, meaning when he was near the tree. And barakallahu fikum, this is very important point that the people of tasawuf, they want to use to say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is that which the tree, Allah manifested himself in the tree and he spoke out of the tree. You see how the game that they're playing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke to Musa when he was near the tree with voices that Musa alayhi salatu wasalam heard, with voices that Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam heard. But them, the Ahlul Tasawwuf, Ahlul Batil, and other than them, they establish that indeed this is the tree that speak to Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. If a brother, he's behind the curtain, and he will speak to me, and I'm right next to the microphone, would we say that that's the microphone that spoke to me, or this is the brother that is behind the curtain that spoke to me? So the people of Tasawwuf, they ascribe the statement to the what? To the tree. And in this, they say Allah, he put himself in the tree, wal-iyadu billah. And we know that from the aqidah of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, لِأَنَّ اللَّهَ بَائِنٌ عَنْ خَلْقِهِ, that Allah is far distant from his creation. So وَوَجَدَ أَنَّ اللَّهَ جَلَّ وَعَلَى يُكَلِّمُهُ مِنَ الشَّجَرَةِ, and he realized that Allah was speaking to him from the tree. He say, كَمَا ذَكَرَ اللَّهُ ذَلِكَ فِي الْقُرْآنِ. He say, as Allah, he mentioned this in the Qur'an. وَسَمِعَ مُوسَى كَلَامُهُ, and Musa, he heard the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قَالَ اللَّهُ جَلَّ وَعَلَى, in Surah An-Nisa, verse number 164. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, وَكَلَّمَ اللَّهُ مُوسَى تَكْلِيمًا, and verily Allah, he spoke to Musa. And verily, Allah, he spoke to Musa. وَكَلَّمَ اللَّهُ مُوسَى تَكْلِيمًا. And this is also the importance where people now cannot do nothing with the istilahat. But now they're going to attack the text itself. They're going to attack the text by changing the wording. By changing the wording or the vowel mass that is in the text. Instead of saying وَكَلَّمَ اللَّهُ, meaning putting a dhamma on Allahu, they would say وَكَلَّمَ اللَّهَ, to make the maf'ul Allah. Wal-iyadu billah. Instead of making the fa'il Allah, wa kallama Allahu, with the dhamma to make the fa'il, meaning the doer or the speaker to make it Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, they make the one that the action is being done on to be Allah. So therefore that they say that Musa spoke to Allah, wal-iyadu billah. Where the text, the nusus, it comes to say, wa kallama Allahu Musa taklima. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-A'raf, he mentioned, وَلَمَّا جَاءَ مُوسَى لِمِيقَاتِنَا وَكَلَّمَهُ رَبُّهُ, and when Musa came to our meeting, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke with him. And his Lord spoke with him. So what else can they do with this? Except that they will say that it means that Allah gave him the affairs. وَكَلَّمَهُ رَبُّهُ, that his Lord speak with him, spoke to him. Now they cannot do no changing in the wording in here. But rather they will bring a meaning and distort the meaning of the Qur'an. وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. The Shaykh حفظه الله say, هذه أمور ثابتة لما وعده الله أن يعطيه التوراة. ذهب موسى لميعاده وكلمه ربه وأعطاه الوحي وأعطاه اللوح التوراة الواحي التوراة مكتوبة فسمعه موسى كلام الله عز وجل. He said when Allah promised Musa that he will give him the revelation, and Musa he went towards the meeting with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he said Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him the Tawrat. He, Musa, heard the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He say, the same way that Allah spoke to Musa, he say, وَكَلَّمَ نَبِيُّنَا مُحَمَّدًا صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ لَيْلَةَ الْمِعْرَاجِ. And he say, the same way, barakallahu fikum, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke to Musa, he spoke to our messenger Muhammad صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ in the night journey. And he say, وَفَرَّضَ عَلَيْهِ الصَّلَوَاتِ الْخَمْسِ. And he made the Salatul Khams wajib upon the people, meaning one of the pillars of the deen. He say, فَاللَّهُ يَتَكَلَّمْ جَلَّ وَعَلَى بِكَلَامٍ يُسْمَعْ وَبِحَرْفٍ وَصَوْتٍ. He say that Allah, our Lord, he will speak with statement that you will hear, that contain a sawt, meaning as a voice, and that also contain what? Harf. So this shows what? That what you heard, meaning the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, can be recited. Sultan, meaning it can be recited. Wahuruf, it can be written, the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the statement is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He say, Amma al-Jahmiyya. And as far as the group that deviated from this, and this is why the people of the Sunnah, they want to be upon the Sunnah, in all aspects of the Sunnah. They do not want to be among those that will pick and choose what sunnah they will affirm and what establishment from the statement of Allah they will establish. What names and attributes from Allah they will establish. He say, أَمَّا الْجَهْمِيَّ وَالْمُعْتَزِلَةِ. He say, as far as the Jahmiyyah and the Mu'tazila, فَيَقُولُونَ, they will say, Allahu la yatakallam. That they will say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not speaking. The Jahmiyyah are those that establish that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only has seven names and attributes. So all the other attributes of Allah that is not coinciding with their uqul, they put it in the trash can, wal'iyadu billah. They will not believe in it. Just because of what they does, those names is not in point with their uqul, nor with their understanding. And likewise, the Mu'tazila in this point. And they will say, لِأَنَّ لو أثبتنا له الكلام شبهناه بالمخلوقين. He said, why? They only say, why? Because if we affirm that Allah speaks, doing this, we are making resemblance Allah with His creation. So here is, you are running away from a calamity and you find yourself in a worse calamity, in a greater calamity. You say that you are not establishing this that Allah established for Himself. So meaning that you are relying on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Because you say that if we will establish that Allah speaks, we will make a resemblance with the creation. And whoever resembles Allah to his creation has also disbelief. So running from a matter to a worse matter or to a greater matter. And this is that which the Mu'tazila was upon, and the Jahmiyyah. And they are still upon this. And whoever man sara ala nahjihim, and whoever embarked on the same belief and the same aqidah. And he say, لِأَنَّ الْمَخْلُوقَ يَتَكَلَّمْ. Why? Because the people, the creation, they will speak. He say, وَهَلْ يُقَاسُ كَلَامُ اللَّهِ بِكَلَامِ الْمَخْلُوقِ. Do we make an analogy between the kalam of Allah and the kalam of the makhluq? Do we make the analogy between the kalam of Allah and the kalam of the makhluqat? And we're going to know this easily, the difference between the speech of the human being or the speech of the creation and the speech of the creator is very simple. That the speech of the creator is not created. It is with him. And every single attributes and names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is not created. Why? Because it follows the asl of Allah, which that Allah, he is not created. So whatever belongs to Allah, or whatever is a yani attribute of Allah, or a name of Allah, will follow the essence of Allah, which is what? Which is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the essence of Allah is that he is not created. But now when you take the state, the speech or the thought, the speech of the human being or the creation, they will follow the same asl. And what is the asl of the creation? That they are created. So therefore, by essence, you and I being created, that lead that everything that we do is created. Everything from your attributes is created. Just like you are tall, it is created that you are tall. Just like it is created that you are short, it is your attribute. And that will come to be an end, barakallahu fikum. But as far as the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that is not created, and it did not have a starting point, nor it will have an ending point. So he say, فَهُمْ لَا يُفَرِّقُونَ بَيْنَ اللَّهِ وَبَيْنَ الْمَخْلُوقِ وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. He said, therefore, this individual that have this belief, they cannot make the distinction between Allah and who? And the creation. The distinction between Allah, or the difference between us and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is that Allah is the creator. And we are the creation. But these people, they cannot make this distinction. That's why they will say, we will not establish that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks. Why? Because saying that he speaks will make us say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is in resemblance with his creation. Wal-iyadu billah. The Shaykh Hafizahullah, he went to say, he said that indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke, and indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speak. He say, فَاللَّهُ جَلَّ وَعَلَىٰ يَتَكَلَّمْ حَقِيقِيَّةً بِكَلَامٍ يُسْمَعُ. He say that Allah really speak with a voice that can be heard, that is heard. والقرآن من كلام الله. And the Quran is from the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يتكلم الله به. And Allah, he speak through the Quran. وتكلم بالتوراة. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by way of the Torah, he speak. وتكلم بالإنجيل. And also by the way of the Bible. ويتكلم متى شاء إذا شاء. He said that Allah speaks anytime that he wants to, about anything that he wants to. He says, فَكَلَامُهُ مِنْ فِعْلِهِ جَلَّ وَعَلَىٰ. And the speech of Allah is part of the actions of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The speech of Allah is part of the actions of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just like barakallahu fikum, Shaykh Uthaymeen rahimahullah, he mentioned, that he say that from the asl of the actions is the af'al. The asl of the actions is the af'al. So in here you will divide the actions into two, into the statement and also in that which you do with your body limbs. So the Shaykh Hafizahullah, he say, وَفِعْلُهُ لَا نِهَايَةَ لَهُ. And the actions of Allah don't have no end, barakallahu fikum. وَلَا بِدَايَةَ لَهُ. And they don't have no starting point, أَحْسَنَ اللَّهُ إِلَيْكُمْ. He say, يَتَكَلَّمُ مَتَى شَاءَ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with his speech, he speaks anytime he wants to. إِذَا شَاءَ. When he speaks, بِمَا شَاءَ. About whatever he want to speak, or to whomever he want to speak to. And he say, فَالْكَلَامُ صِفَةٌ. That the kalam is one of the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. مِنْ صِفَةِ الْفِعْلِيَّةِ. In those action of those attributes of the action. But one have to make sure that you cannot name Allah al-mutakallim. One cannot say that because the sifat of Allah being that he speaks, you cannot call Allah the speaker. Not because that Allah, he has the attributes that he speaks, we cannot say that he is the speaker. We know that Allah provides. So can we say he is the provider? Yes. Can we say that Allah, he is the one that gives life? Yes, he is the one that gives life. and one of his attributes is that he gives life. But one cannot say that Allah is the speaker. Why? Because you will divide the speech into three categories. Like Shaykh Uthaymeen rahimahullah mentioned in those, for those who read Aqidatul Wasatiyya, he mentioned that the kalam, yuqsamul kalam ila ala thalatha aqsam. He said that the state, the kalam, speech is divided into three. And we understand something from get-go, that there is no sharr, there is no evil in the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let us all agree that there is no nuqsan in the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And His names and attributes, they are all complete in its perfection. So Shaykh Uthaymeen rahimahullah, he say that the statement or the speech is divided into three. And I want the brothers to pay attention to this. He say one is that the statement or the speech that is good in itself. It is good in itself. Masalan, the Quran, it is the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's a speech. So is it a good speech? Yes. Does it have anything that is despicable in it? No. Everything in it is good. You read the book of Allah, one harf, you have 10 hasanat. So this is good in itself, barakallahu feekum. And you have the other category of the kalam, which is what? Is the kalam that is evil in itself. Evil in itself, masalan, a person saying lies against his own self even, let alone against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Or a person speaking ill of the ulama, or a person speaking about the matter of the deen that he don't have no understanding. This is what? A kalamu su. This is an evil statement. This is an evil statement that he made it. Make it. Can we ascribe that to Allah? Never ever. We cannot say that Allah, He has evil in His speech, wal-iyadu billah. And also another category, the third category of the speech is what? Is a speech that does not contain no fa'idah, but at the same token, it does not have no harm in it. Masalan, if a person would have stand up and start cracking jokes, saying things that don't have no importance, meaning he will not be reprimanded by Allah in it, because he's not saying something that is haram in it. But no, he will not have no reward from Allah. Why? Because he's not saying nothing that can allow him to have the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Mathala, a person stands up and says, Subhanallah. We know that he will be rewarded by Allah because he's remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Can we ascribe this third category from Allah? No. Because Allah, like the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he say, Ash-sharru laysa ilayka, that the evil is nowhere near from you. So that this is why, barakallahu fikum, Allah, He speaks, but we cannot say that Allah is the speaker. أقول بما تسمعون واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعد والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين. My brothers, barakallahu feekum, these issues of the aqidah is something that is very important that one has to know only through learning it. One has to know only by learning it. One has to devote himself to learn what is the aqidah of the sunnah, or what is the aqidah of the salaf al-salih, what was the aqidah of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq. And in here, barakallahu fikum, we ascribe that Allah indeed He speaks, but we will not say that He is a speaker. Because saying that He is a speaker, then all those three will go to Him. And we know that the two are not befitting for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the Shaykh Hafidhahullah, meaning the statement of Imam al-Barbahari when he say, Minhu subhanahu la bi ghayrihi. Meaning that Musa, he heard the speech of Allah, the voice of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Meaning he heard that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was speaking to him. He say he didn't hear it from anybody else. And this is what we were mentioning about what is the people of tasawwuf. They want to utilize that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he was in the tree. Wal-iyadu billah. How come? When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed Himself to the mountain crushed. And how come the tree can bear to have to have Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his essence. Look at the evil of the people of tasawwuf. Look at the evil of the people of the Jahmiyya. Look at the evil of the people of the Mu'tazila. Why all of this? Because they did not study the aqidah of the Salaf. Why? Because they did not study the aqidah of Abu Bakr and all the companions upon. He said, La min al-shajara. It is not from the tree. He said, La min al-lawhul mahfuz. And Musa alayhi salatu wasalam did not hear voice from the tree, nor from lawhul mahfuz. Wa la min Jibreel. And the voice was not from Jibreel. La min Muhammad. And the voice was not from Muhammad sallallahu alayhi sallam. Fahuwa kalamun biyadillahi jalla wa ala. He said, it is indeed a statement that was from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That was a true statement from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He say, وَإِنَّمَا جِبْرِيلُ وَمُحَمَّدٌ نَاقِلَانِ عَنِ اللَّهِ. He say that indeed Jibreel and Muhammad, they only convey that which is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the statement is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just like what he said, that the one that conveyed, the statement is not from the one that conveyed. But rather the statement is the one from is from the one that said it first. مثلا, you send your children to go tell your mother to put the dinner on the table. That statement is not from your child when he will go to your to the mother and tell mother, my father say. See exactly the terminology. He say, mother, my father say. As if you would have put a quotation mark on it. Put the dinner on the table. So putting the dinner on the table is what? Is the statement that is from the father. Barakallahu fikum. So the child, he is only narrating. He is only making what is called a tabligh to the mother. So in another point, he say, فَمَنْ قَالَ غَيْرُ ذَلِكَ أَوْ غَيْرُ هَذَا. He say, فَقَدْ كَفَرَ بِاللَّهِ الْعَظِيمِ. And whoever say other than this, that the Qur'an is the speech of Allah, whoever say other than this that Allah speaks, that he has indeed disbelief. وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. He say, مَنْ قَالَ إِنَّ الْكَلَامَ إِنَّ كَلَامُ اللَّهُ مَخْلُوقٌ وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَتَكَلَّمُ وَعَطَّلَ اللَّهَ مِنْ كَلَامٍ فَهُوَ كَافِرٌ لِأَنَّهُ مَكْذُوبٌ لِلَّهِ وَلِلرَّسُولِ وَلِإِجْمَاعِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. اللَّهُمَّ إِنْ إلا أن يكون جاهلا أو متأولا أو مقدلا لمن حسن بهم. He say that for verily, whoever say that the statement of Allah is created, or he say that Allah does not speak, or he deform the words that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks, he say, فَهُوَ كَافِرٌ. He is indeed a disbeliever. Why? Because he is belying upon Allah, and he is belying upon the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he is belying upon the consensus of the Muslims. He say, Allahumma accept that he is from the juhal, from those yani ignorant ones, or those that are using a ta'wil, meaning they are bringing their own understanding as far as bringing a wording into it. He say, those individuals, you explain them the issue. You clarify them the issue. He say, if they now, they refuse. He say, صَارَ حُكِمَ بِكُفْرٍ لِأَنَّ اللَّهَ جَلَّ وَعَلَىٰ عَابَ عَلَى الْمُشْرِكِينَ أَنَّهُمْ يَعْبُدُونَ التَّمَاثِيلَ الَّتِي لَا يَتَكَلَّمُونَ. He say that if they will refuse now to accept the word, to accept the evidences, he said that the ruling of them being kuffar will take place. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described the kuffar that they were worshipping, the idols that they were worshipping were not speaking, did not have the ability of speech. So if now those that used to worship the idols are still worshipping the idols, and the idols cannot speak, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala named them as what? Tamathil. So this is the same thing that they ascribe to Allah to be a tamathil. Why? Because they say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not speak. So therefore, they are worshipping an idol. Wal-iyadu billah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he say, when Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam, he addressed his father, he say, Ya abati, O you my father, lima ta'budu ma la yasma'u, wa la yadurru, wa la yanfa'uka, wa la yughnika anka shay'a. He say, O you my father, why is it that you are worshipping something that is not, that they have the ability to hear you? So here you mean what? That if you speak, he cannot speak back. See the wording that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used. He didn't say directly, why are you worshipping something that cannot speak? But Allah, He say, Ya Ibrahim, in the tongue of Ibrahim, when He say, Ya Abati, O you my father, Lima ta'budu ma la yasma'. Why is it that you're worshipping something that cannot hear? Meaning, when you speak to Him, He cannot speak back. See the eloquence that is in the Quran, barakallahu feekum. He say, He didn't say, why are you speaking to something? Why are you worshipping something that cannot speak? He didn't say that. He say, why are you worshipping something that cannot hear? Meaning, when you speak to Him, they cannot respond back. So barakallahu feekum, that our aqeedah is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He speaks. Our aqeedah is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks whenever He wants to, however He wants to, and to whoever, whomever He wants to. And we know, barakallahu feekum, those that deviated from this, if they are doing it after the text is being clear to them, they are belying upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they are belying upon the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And they are belying upon the ijma of the Muslim. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those that will be firm upon the aqidah of the Salaf, to die upon it. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to resurrect us with those that take the same path, meaning the messengers, the shuhada, and those who fought in the jihad, and those who are the truthful ones, and those that are the salihin. And verily indeed, this is the best gathering. Wa sallallahu ala Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in.
استووا اعتدلوا تراصوا خاضوا بين المناقب والأقدام. Put your heels and your shoulders together. Don't leave no gaps in between you. استووا تراصوا. Let your toes, your heels.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حيا الصلاة حيا الصلاة حكامة الصلاة حكامة الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
استووا اعتدلوا الله اكبر سبحانك الله ربنا وبحمدك تبارك اسمك وتعالى جده ولا اله الا انت الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين اياك نعبد واياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا إذا نودي للصلاة من يوم الجمعة فاسعوا إلى ذكر الله وذروا البيع ذلكم خير لكم إن كنتم تعلمون فإذا قضيت الصلاة فانتشروا في الأرض وابتغوا من فضل الله واذكروا الله كثيرا لعلكم تفلحون وإذا رأوا تجارة أو لهوا انفضوا إليها وتركوك قائما قل ما عند الله خير من اللهو ومن التجارة
والله خير الرازقين. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. سبحان الله. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. تبت يدا أبي لهب وتب، ما أغنى عنه ماله وما كسب، سيصلى نارا ذات لهب، وامرأته حمالة الحطب، في جيدها حبل من مسد. قل هو الله أحد، الله الصمد، لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. قل أعوذ برب الناس، ملك الناس، إله الناس، من شر الوسواس الخناس، الذي يوسوس في صدور الناس، من الجنة والناس. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم.
Assalamu alaikum, brothers. One moment, please. Inshallah, since we've taken on this great task of this masjid here, it's been great benefit. However, we would like to continue that on in the masjid. We need your help here, and hopefully that everybody can get rewards. As men, Allah says that we are the maintainer of the masjid. So inshallah, let's not the shaitan threaten us with poverty, and please give to the house of Allah. And that way, our family, and we can continue to come to the masjid and maintain the masjid. Barakallahu feekum.
Alhamdulillah.